Breakfast with Mark Simpson. The sun's just come up. It looks like it's going to be a great day. The forecast is dry and bright. They said that yesterday and we had torrential rain.
Zombies.
In a moment, we'll have a look at London's traffic news from Sally at Scotland Yard, and then we'll have the national roundup from AA Roadwatch. Coming up next, the news at 6.
Move yourself, Satan. God almighty, move, dog! Don't know why you can't sit in the back like other Alsatians. Memo to Dexter Willis. Dexter, you are my old and trusted business partner. And I know that you have been advised by your doctor to take, and I quote, a short break from work to recuperate from the stress caused by the recent and uncharacteristic aberration of your fragrant wife, Tina. Ipso facto, her having it off with the insurance salesman. I remember well the day you found out about her affair, and, although you tried hard to hide it, I could sense your anxiety. And as a friend, I felt nothing but sympathy for the both of you. And, naturally, am delighted that the reconciliation is going so well. But, also as a friend, and not wishing to appear mercenary or insensitive, I must remind you that we are running a business, i.e. Cresta Cabs, and I feel that, and again I quote, a short break does not constitute a whole sodding month in Barbados and a 3-week convalescence since your return. We are, as you are aware, short of drivers as it is, and I earnestly urge you to get your arse in gear and get back to work. End memo.
So that's the latest travel news we have from AA Roadwatch. We'll have more for you in 20 minutes. In just a moment, we'll have the national news and local traffic news after this.
I'm off to work. I'll see you later.
Basil, it's been a smash-up on the motorway just outside Leeds, and there's snow in the Welsh mountains.
Oh, thank you, Marlon.
And they said to avoid the M46 just outside Swindon.
Marlon, I'm only going to the Cricklewood sorting office.
Yeah, but you could get lost, Basil.
Yes, but I'm hardly likely to pedal into the Welsh mountains, am I?
Oh, Henry at Cresta Cabs gets lost.
Yeah, but that's because he's new to the country. I mean, he only came over from Nigeria a few months back. I mean, he's bound to find it confusing.
I used to fly an helicopter for the Air Sea Rescue Service, so I know how easy it is for people to get lost.
Oh, of course, I forgot. Now listen, if Sam from Cresta Cabs calls, tell him I won't be working today. I've got an appointment this afternoon. You could go down to the cab office if you've nothing better to do.
No, Basil, I've got a very busy day ahead of me.
All right, what are you up to?
I'm designing a new Concorde.
Oh, good. Oh, not before time, either. I'll see you.
They say we're young and we don't
know. Where's the parcel going? Won't find out
until
okay. 11:15? Yep, we'll have a driver there.
Any work for me, Reen?
Oh, you're last on the list, Andre. Another hour, maybe?
Okay, anyone wants me, I'll be in my dark room.
Were you working last night, Andre?
Yeah, there was a school reunion up at the Mount View Hotel and they asked me to do the photography. Boring work, but the money's good.
Are you singing tonight, Phil?
No, but I'm doing a Friday and Saturday night gig.
Oh, yes? Where?
Rose and Crown.
Right. Well, that's us down to Coach and Horses for the weekend.
Oh, love it, love it.
Henry, there's a parcel for Southampton to be picked up in 10 minutes from Austin Price Publishing.
OK, Reen.
And don't forget to ask if it's going express or by normal service. And fill in the form correctly.
No problem, Sam.
Go on, then. Art and literature.
Who wrote The Sabre Dance?
Over to you, Phil. You're the musician.
That's classical, I only do rock and roll.
Oh, it's simple.
Oh, come on, Phil. I hate listening to Barry. You must have some idea. You went to college.
Yeah, but I studied plumbing. Sabre dance.
Where's Andre?
He's in his dark room.
He's had that dark room for 6 months now.
Well, he makes a bit of money doing photography on the side.
Yeah, but I wish he'd pay me a bit of rent on the side.
Was it Tchaikovsky?
You tosser. Of course it wasn't Tchaikovsky. Tchaikovsky wrote, them other things. It was Kachaturian.
Oh, yeah, of course.
Don't believe you, Phil. Kachaturian? You could have sneezed and got that one, right?
Henry, don't forget that parcel.
Oh, I'm on my way now, Reen. OK, Next question. Sport and leisure.
Are you all right, Cop?
Who won the World Cup in 1970?
Are you the man who had an affair with a married lady? Haven't you not got work to do?
What lady, Marlon?
Mr. Dexter's wife. Oh.
No. I didn't have an affair with Dexter's wife. It was in insurance sales.
How did this boy know about that?
He's in the office, he hears people talking.
Look, Marlon, this is private and confidential matters, and you mustn't mention them, particularly in front of Dexter, otherwise you will discover what the term apeshit means.
I had an affair with a married lady once, but I mustn't tell you her name.
Good.
Bruce Willis was really annoyed. Do we need this?
Oh, shut up, you horrible man.
I'm trying to run a business here, and this place is starting to look like the foyer of the Crossroads Motel.
Marlon, why don't you go and buy yourself a kebab? I'll tell you what, get one for Basil and take it home to him.
I like it in a kebab shop, when they cut the meat off the elephant's leg. Shall I get the one in the bread?
Yeah, good idea.
Shall I get relish as well?
Yeah, why not? Get the lot.
All right.
Have you heard from Dexter today?
Not a word. I don't want to worry you too much, Sam, but we're running out of drivers. I put that ad in the local paper, but so far no one's applied for the job.
Dexter, my erstwhile business partner, is supposed to drive. I find it incredible. I mean, here we are, up to our eyes in work, and we've got the Brent Cross sales coming up, and Dexter goes walkabout. How things can change so fast, eh? I mean, a few years back, Dexter was here working. He was a rock, a real business partner. And then right out of the blue, he goes and meets some bird half his age.
Tina? At least give her a name, Sam.
Yes, he met Tina and announces that he's fallen in love. Do you remember we all rushed outside to watch that squadron of low-flying pigs go past? I tried to warn him, Reen. I said to him, I said, Dexter, don't rush in. But what does he do? He bought that big house, has it all decorated and furnished to Tina's taste. They even gave her own gold card, which is rather like letting Douglas Bader go bungee jumping. He'd married her 3 months later. And now, surprise, surprise, she has an affair with a young insurance salesman. There's no fool like an old fool, Reen.
Oh, come on, Sam, have some sympathy. You know how Tina's affair affected him? He had a nervous breakdown.
Dexter is not intelligent enough to have a breakdown. And as for nervous, we are talking about a man who once, for a bet, ran into a mosque and shouted minicab for Mr. Rushdie.
What do you think, Dexter?
Yeah, I like it too.
It's supposed to be of a waterfall.
So why ain't it?
It is. It's abstract. Can't you imagine it above our fireplace?
Yeah. Do you think it'll go with the wallpaper?
Oh, well, I'm having it all changed, aren't I, like Mr. Choi told us to.
That's right. Do you really like it, Tim?
I love it. I saw it about 3 months ago and I've been dreaming about it ever since.
Who'd you come up here with 3 months ago? Him?
No, it's me mum. Don't keep going on about him, will you, Dexter? It's all in the past. Remember what the doctor told you.
Yeah, all right. Do you want it, love?
Yeah. I love it. Almost as much as I love you.
All right, then. Nobler.
Sir?
How much is that?
It's a Hugo Duarte. He is one of the leading lights of the Madrid School.
Yeah, I know. How much?
It's £15,000.
It's a bit much for a painting by a schoolboy, isn't it?
When I said the Madrid School, I meant...
Oh, you'll have to forgive my husband. He's having you on.
I see.
We'll take it.
Of course you will.
Andre, about the rent on this place. There's no hurry, Cock. You just pay me when you can. Whoop! That looks technical. Well, I won't keep you any longer. Good man.
Are we going to the ladies' shop, Basil?
It's not called the ladies' shop, Marlon. It's a dating bureau. And you be on your best behaviour in there.
I like that girl out of Friends. The pretty one. She's in a new series now about shampoo.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I know her. I directed one of her films.
Yeah, I remember.
Hey, yeah, I won an Oscar.
Yeah, that's right.
You heard from Henry?
No, nothing yet. I can't get him on his radio either.
Zombie. Phone the parcel office, Waterloo Station. See if he's there chatting.
Right.
Oh, Dexter! How lovely of you to pop in and see us.
I've been busy.
Evidently.
What do you think?
Well, it's a bit happy eater, isn't it?
We've had this Chinese bloke around the house, Mr. Choi. He's a Feng Shui expert. Sam, I'm telling you now. Feng Shui is brilliant. The Four Dog Swingers. I don't suppose you've ever heard of it.
Yes, I have. And it's Feng Shui. The ancient Chinese mystical art of placing the furniture in the home to gain harmony with nature and attain the greatest spiritual advantages for prosperity, health and happiness.
Sort of. Anyway, he reckons that it's the design of our house that's caused all me and Tina's problems.
What? Nothing to do with her and that insurance bloke having a, you know.
No! Apparently, Tina had no say in the matter. It was the way we positioned our settee. It caused her to be the victim of malevolent spirits.
You little bastards.
Anyway, I never liked to tell you where it was. It used to catch the sun. And sometimes, you couldn't see the ball. It's what you and Tommy want to get into, Reed. Feng Shui. Change your luck. The first thing you want to do is get rid of all the old rubbish from your house.
Leave off, Dex. We'd have nowhere to sit.
Oh, me and Tina are into it in a big way. We're having the old house redecorated.
Well, you've just had the house redecorated.
Yeah, but this time it's being designed by Mr. Choi, according to the theories of Feng Shui. Mr. Choi even recommends that we employ artwork of a calming nature. So we went up to town this morning and bought a picture of a waterfall by Hugo Duarte.
Hugo Duarte. I know him. It's very good.
You knew him? Well, you could have said. I could have got it a bit cheaper.
No! I don't know him. Morning, Hugo. Sort of know him. I mean, I often read about him in the Independence Arts page.
Well, I often read about Alan Shearer in The Sun, but I don't go round telling everyone that he's my mate.
No, I don't mean that.
You're a right old sponsor sometimes, aren't you, Sam?
Wait a moment. You bought a Duarte?
£15,000.
15 grand?
Tina loved it. And the thing this incident taught me is money means nothing. Happiness is what it's all about. You couldn't understand what she means to me. She's an outgoing, bubbly person. She's also very fanciful.
What do you mean I couldn't understand? My Muriel was very fanciful.
She weren't, Sam.
She was?
She weren't.
She was.
She weren't. She was very attractive, but she weren't fanciful.
She was.
She weren't.
She was.
She weren't.
Well, I fancied her.
Well, you fancied her, yeah. But my Tina's different. She needs a lot of attention.
She gets it, don't she?
Absolutely. I'm just going to phone home and see how she is.
Hey,
Hello.
Who's that?
The painter.
Oh, right. Can I speak to Tina?
Who?
The lady of the house.
Oh, no, she went out earlier.
Oh, OK. Thanks.
Her husband said he was taking her out to lunch.
Dexter? Are you all right?
Tina. Tina's gone out to lunch with her husband.
Her husband? But you're a... Oh, Dexter. Oh, Dexter, Dexter, Dexter.
That slag, filthy bitch, slag woman. What do you mean, her husband?
I'm her husband.
Hey? Oh, God, look, I'm sorry. I just assumed it was her husband. He came out of the bedroom.
How was I to know?
I'm only working part-time.
Right. OK, I'll tell him. Thank you. Mr. Tyler, she won't keep you long.
Thank you.
I got another lady for you.
Miss Beckett phoned to say she has someone she wants me to meet.
Are you going to take her to that Chinese restaurant?
Oh, yes, I always go there. Well, it's good food, and I know how much everything costs.
Will you bring me back a doggy bag?
Well, of course. But I can't if the lady invites me back to her home for a cup of coffee.
Don't be silly.
Could happen, Marlon.
Oh, stop it.
You go down to Cresta Cabs today?
Yeah. Oh. Green asked me to give you this.
Oh. It's nice of her. No, Mr. Collis, you can't call me back. I'm not at home. I'm working in a private house. I really shouldn't be making this call. Your bank wrote to me this morning to say I was behind on my car repayments. Yes, but I'd written to you earlier to explain my financial situation. You see, I'm only working part-time at the moment. Well, it's the only work I could get. No, I've never considered you to be a charity, Mr. Collis. It's just that your TV commercials claim you're the bank that understands.
I'd like to go and find them, Sam. I'd like to ram their kin starters down their kin throats.
Dexter, my advice to you, for what it's worth, is stay calm. My father always said to
me... I want revenge!
Fine! But remember your mistakes of the past. Don't take it out on human flesh and bone. Take your revenge out on inanimate objects.
Stuff that! I'm gonna go and smash her new furniture up.
Or take it out on the furniture instead.
I know what I'm gonna take it out on. The bastard painter's using my phone!
But I simply can't afford this month's repayment. No, I don't have time to pop in and see you. I'm working. Look, if I could just extend the repayment period... Yes. Well, I'll pop in and see you. This afternoon? Yeah. Bye. Hello?
You been using my phone?
No. Someone called. Wrong number.
Listen, pal, do you want to make yourself a £500 bonus?
£500? Yes, please.
Right. There is a big painting in the front room. You seen it?
Oh, no. Not the Duarte. Dexter, you cannot do this. This is art.
The one above the fireplace?
Eddie, now I want you to take it down, take it outside, smash it to pieces, and then burn it. And I want it done before my wife comes home.
Give me that.
See how she likes her pride and joy going up in flames, and it's an original.
Smash it up and burn it? I can't do that. It's a work of art.
Of course you can't. Ignore the man. He's a psychopath.
Who's this?
I'm his partner.
Listen, Nobbler, it is my work of art. Now, if I want to burn it, then I will sod him well burn it.
Now, do you want the money or don't you?
Of course I do, yeah. £500. Well, I suppose legally he's entitled to do what he wants
with his own property.
Sadly, yes.
Oh, God.
Feng Shui. Chinese bollocks, more like.
So, how's life treating you, Basil?
Oh, not too bad, thank you, Miss Beckett.
Eve?
Oh, thank you.
Just had a very nice lady join the agency, and we think the two of you might get on rather well.
Oh, thank you.
Mrs. Hopkins, separated 2 years, divorce imminent, not sure of her age, early 40s, I'd guess.
Oh, I'll find out for you.
No, don't ask her age, Basil. Never ask a lady's age.
Oh, right.
Would this evening suit you? 8:30?
Oh, yes, thank you.
Where do you suggest you meet? The Golden Rickshaw Chinese Restaurant?
How about the Golden Rickshaw Chinese Restaurant? It's on Crompton Street.
Yes, she'll find it. Basil, don't lose faith. We know your dates haven't worked out as well as we'd all hoped, but this often happens with new crimes.
Of course, but I don't know. I think I must be doing something a bit wrong. I mean, I meet a lady and start talking to her, and then after a while I see, I don't know, there's something in her eyes. It's difficult to explain, but well, I know immediately I haven't clicked.
What happens to their eyes?
Well, they become sort of glazed.
Talk about?
Well, I tell them all about myself.
Mistake.
How I came down from Manchester for the 1981 Cup Final between Spurs and Man City. How I met Astrid, my future wife. She was a barmaid in a pub near Wembley. And we married after a whirlwind romance. And then she left me 4 weeks later with her son, my stepson, Marlon. And I tell them all about him, you know, how he has sort of special needs. I also mention that I'm a postman and generally tell them a little about the postal service because people haven't a clue what goes on in a sorting office. I mean, most people think you just post a letter and that's the end of it. I mean, you should see their faces when I tell them what really happens.
I bet.
I also tell them that I'm a part-time minicab driver.
Why?
Well, just to add a bit of colour. Anyway, it's round about then, as I say, that I see, you know, something in their eyes. Do you think I'm doing something wrong?
I scored the winning try in the British Lions Tour of South Africa, 1973. It was a bloody good one, I know. I used to be a superb rugby player.
How about taking a new approach to your basic subject matter?
Oh, yes, yes. Yes, what exactly does that mean?
In other words, you could try and think of something else to speak about. Travel.
Oh, yes, thank you. Good.
Have you travelled much?
No. When I came down to London for the 1981 Cup Final, it was my first time out of Manchester.
Yes, well, just try to be a bit more positive.
Positive? Right.
Still there?
Yes, yes.
Yes, we're still here.
I've done it.
Good. I'm on my way home and I'll bring the money.
Great, thanks. I better warn you now, a lot of the ash is floating in your swimming pool.
Yes, well, I think that's the least of his what? Swimming pool. Have you got a swimming pool now?
What swimming pool?
This is Potter's Bar 649193, isn't it?
No, this is 649194.
Hi.
Hello.
How's it going? What's that?
What do you do today?
I'm minicabbed.
I know that. I mean, what would you do?
I drove a minicab for 12 hours. People said drive me there. I drove them there, then I drove back.
Oh, as long as you had fun. How's Dexter these days?
Oh, still the same. Went in the office today, and Dexter had Sam by the throat. Me and Reen had to pull him off. I think they were arguing about having the place redecorated. Dexter kept shouting out about some painter called Hugo. Tell you that Barbados holiday did him no good.
Barbados? Oh. Remember our last holiday, Hastings in October?
Yeah. Still, as caravans go, it weren't bad. Me and you go to Barbados one day, Chris.
Yeah? What's the plan? We both get jobs as holiday reps?
One record. That's all I need, you'll see.
Are you singing tomorrow night?
Yeah, we've got a gig.
Can me and Shay come and sing one night?
No, you're not allowed in pubs.
I don't sing in pubs. I do clubs and arenas.
Where are you tomorrow?
Rose and Crown.
Rose and Crown. That's a funny name for a club when you think about it, isn't it? If you say it fast, it doesn't half sound like a pub.
All right, it is a pub. But it's not a pub pub. It's a well-respected venue on the circuit. All the greats have played there.
Like who?
Stones, U2, Oasis.
Liar.
It's true!
Is it really, Daddy?
No.
Right, I'm going to get your beds ready. And no laying there talking for hours tonight. You've got to be up early in the morning. I'm taking them round to your mum's tomorrow. She was on the phone earlier. I never see Cher and Madonna. Nobody loves me. Moan and groan.
Mm. You give Nanny a big kiss from me.
Nanny's got black lumps on her legs.
Well, don't kiss her legs. Peck on her cheek will do. Yes, sweetheart.
What's a prat?
Did you say that in Winnie the Pooh?
Miss Jones said it at school.
Well, your teacher said that to you?
No. Me and Cher had to go to the staff room and the teachers were all talking and laughing. And we heard Miss Jones say that.
Well, it's not a word you girls should be using. It means a fool, somebody who's stupid.
And what's a wannabe? It's an Australian marsupial.
No, that's a wannabe. A wannabe is someone who wants to be something else but can't. OK? Now, say goodnight to Daddy.
Night, Daddy. Mm-hmm. Night, Daddy.
Night, night, sweetheart. Mm-hmm. Night, darling.
And no talking. Straight to sleep.
You happy with that school the girls go to?
It's a nice school. Don't want to move them now. They've settled in nicely. I think they like it there. I think they feel a bit special.
Why is that?
It's a bit of reflected glory. They had all the teachers talking about you today.
Yeah?
Jealousy, Ring. A savage, unthinking beast. Like a tide of self-deception engulfing the island of logic. A forest fire of unwarranted conclusion destroying the parklands of sweet reason.
You say so, Sam.
Suspicion plus anger equals an empty space above some poor sod's fireplace.
How must them people be feeling tonight? That painting could have been a family heirloom, priceless to them.
Exactly. And what was Dexter's reaction to the outcome? I mean, did he feel apology or restitution was in order? Did he feel a sense of remorse for his mistake? Like hell, all he felt was pure relief. His feng shui protected house was safe, his precious painting was extremely unscorched, and his fragrant wife Tina hadn't banged an insurance salesman all day.
Sam?
Hmm?
I wanted to remind you about tomorrow.
Tomorrow? What's tomorrow then?
It was 2 years ago tomorrow that.
Good night, Green. Good night, Sam.
Good night, Henry.
Did you deliver that parcel for Southampton?
Oh, yes, Sam. No problem.
Good man.
It was nice to get a breath of sea air.
Sam, tomorrow...
Sea air? You've delivered it to Southampton. He was supposed to send it Red Star from Waterloo.
It's my fault.
And he's driven all the way to Southampton.
He's new, Sam, and I didn't explain it to him properly.
But he's driven all the way to... Zombie. I'll have a word with him tomorrow. What's that you were saying about tomorrow?
Doesn't matter.
Has the lady gone already, Basil?
Yes, I was right in the middle of telling her what happens to registered and recorded mail when she suddenly remembered she left the gas on, so she had to rush off home to check.
Hopefully we'll be able to arrange the dinner for a later date.
Doggy bag as usual.
Thank you, Lee.
You working tomorrow?
Yeah.
What? Working as in for money?
Yeah, well, in the long run. Sort of grand scheme of things, yeah.
I hate it when you catch these bouts of 24-hour cobblers. What's all that mean?
I'm going down to Graham's studio. Going to work on those recordings of my new songs. Laid down some brilliant bass lines the other day.
Phil, I don't have a row about this, but don't you think it might be more worthwhile doing something... well, more worthwhile?
What could be more worthwhile than my music? I mean, I'm ambitious, Chris. I can't help it.
And I'm not criticising that. Ambition's good. But couldn't you be ambitious in a different direction? I mean, look at Rajiv. He's planning on starting his own minicab firm one day.
Christine, when are you going to understand I'm a professional singer? I need minicab part-time.
Yeah, right. You're a professional singer who gets 2 gigs a month. For the other 341 days of the year, you minicab part-time. Think about it, Phil. Look, I don't want to hurt you. I love you. But what you do in that pub is just one step up from karaoke.
Oh, well, this is great. He used to believe in me once.
I used to believe in the Tooth Fairy once. We met 10 years ago when you just formed the band. There was promise then. There was... I don't know, there was something. But you're 32. Face it, Phil. You're an old chap now.
Do those guys look like teenagers to you?
They've made it. You're allowed to be old when you're successful.
But age doesn't matter when you do the stuff I do.
What, pub singing?
I don't do pubs. Well, not all the time. What has brought this on? Have you been looking in that estate agent's window again?
Don't you dare get sexist with me. Of course, I'm just a little woman with nothing better to do with her day than look in estate agents' windows and dream.
All right, I'm sorry, I was only joking with you. What's wrong?
Well, all right. I was looking in the estate agents today. And they're building some new flats in Gerrard's. Some of them have got 3 bedrooms. The kids could have a room of their own each.
Oh, we'll get one. One day.
Wouldn't you love to live somewhere better?
Of course I would. I'd like a place big enough to have my own recording studios. Bono's got studios in his house in Ireland. And his place in America.
I'd like a place that had a shower.
We've got a shower.
No, I mean one of the new type, the ones where water comes out of them.
Oh, it's water coming out of them now, is it? Oh, we are getting fancy. You know, one of the songs I've written is dedicated to you. It's called Christina.
But my name's Christine.
Well, yeah, I know, but it doesn't sound right, does it? Well, and it doesn't rhyme with Cena.
Cena?
Cena? Christina. Lyrics. Sort of.
any more accounts from last night?
Why don't you look?
What's up with her?
Don't know. Most probably ovulating. Bloody night crew. They're worse than the day crew, and that's saying something.
It's your little words of encouragement that keep us going, Sam.
I keep checking women out to restaurants. They always pay. I wouldn't mind if one of them invited me back to their house for some home cooking.
Yeah, you be careful of that, Basil. It's like walking into the spider's web. You know what women say? Way to a man's heart is through his stomach.
No, not all men. No, I much prefer a screw to a stew. Now, Baz, if you want advice about women, you want to talk to the old Scud missile over there.
Shut up, Barry.
He's got women all over London. He's got more kids than the Waltons.
Barry.
He was circumcised last year and they made a full set of flight luggage out of what was left over.
Andre. Edgeware.
Are you not going to sit around gobbing all day?
Sorry, sir. Oh, no, wait.
Can I help you, sir?
Yeah, I've come about the job advertised in a local paper. Minicab drivers wanted?
Oh, right. Come in. What? Sit down.
Have we met? Your voice sounds familiar.
Really? Well, I did a commercial on local radio a while back.
Oh, that must be it.
Yeah, and my assistant handles interviews. Ring?
Do it yourself.
Yes, we're always sending each other up here at Cresta Cabs. Take a seat and someone will be with you, momentarily. What's wrong?
Nothing.
Come in here. Come on. We're alone. So tell me.
Do you know what today is?
Wednesday.
It was 2 years ago today that you and I... That little hotel down in Burnham on Crouch.
Right.
You'd forgotten about it, hadn't you?
No. Well, I've had a lot on my mind.
I know it was wrong, Sam. But it was nice wrong. Sometimes I remember it now. Oh, look at my life, Sam. Some people are flying off to the Caribbean, but not me. Oh, I've got a husband who spends his life shoving super-duper strength lager down his throat. I've got a nan and granddad who are waiting in God's departure lounge. All I seem to do is work here, go and cook dinner every night for them, and throw Tommy's pissy pants in the washing machine. I think if things had been different, Muriel never ever suspected the chief.
No, of course not. Muriel's gone by then, ring.
Yeah. Tommy never either. Well, he wouldn't, would he?
No. He was away on Galaxy Carlsberg, weren't he?
To me, it... I don't know. It seems to get more important every day. And you just forgot about it?
No, I don't forget about it. Wait a minute. You said we should forget about it.
Yes, I said we should forget about it, but I didn't mean we should forget about it.
No, of course not.
Hello.
Oh, hi.
Do you drive a car?
Yes. It's a four-year-old Cavalier. Four-door.
I used to drive Formula One.
Really? Well, that must have been great.
Yeah. You go really fast.
Yeah, I know. You can reach speeds of 200 miles an hour, can't you?
Yeah.
I know the area pretty well. I was born in Hampstead.
Do you have a mum and dad?
Yes. My dad's a doctor and my mum's a journalist.
Do you like crisps?
Crisps.
What are you up to? Go and get yourself a chalky biscuit. Sorry about that. Right. One of you two will have to do the interview. Henry?
Me? But I've never done an interview before. Yes, of course. I'm new here myself. I have to ask you some questions.
Yes?
Good.
Do you have a clean driving license?
Oh, yes.
No, me.
Oh. Yes. Do you have a clean driving license?
Yes.
Good.
Fill in this form.
But I filled one of these in when I first joined.
Him, him, him!
Oh, sorry. I thought you meant, fill that in. So, what have you been doing?
Well, I finished university, a postgraduate course, about a year ago.
Ooh.
Well, I've been working part-time for a painting and decorating firm. Pretty tough work.
They'll give you a reference, I assume.
No, I don't think so. They fired me.
What for?
I was working in this house, big house, serious money, and, I damaged a painting.
So your firm had to pay to have it repaired?
No. It was beyond repair.
What did you do? Catch it with your stepladder and rip it?
Well, this is going to sound ridiculous, sir. Why, I smashed it up and set light to it.
Oh, I see.
Well, it wasn't my fault. I was a victim of a sick practical joke. Someone phoned up and claimed to be the man of the house. Well, he said burn the painting.
So you burnt it?
Well, he offered me money.
Oh, well, that's different, isn't it?
And you have no idea who phoned you?
No. Well, I was about to call 1471 and get the caller's number, but, at that point, the police rang back.
Henry, give him the job.
What? Can I have a word, please, Sam?
Oi. Cambridge. Do you fancy a coffee?
Yeah, great.
Make us one while you're at it.
Sam, what do you mean give him the job? Did you not hear him? He's just admitted to seeing a work of art for money.
Henry, give him the job.
Sam, that telephone call he received may not have been a telephone call at all. He may be one of those people who hear voices. He might be care in the community, on drugs or both.
Henry, call it intuition. Give him the job.
Oh, I'm so glad we brought Mr. Choi in. I mean, I know it was expensive, £2,500, but look what he's done.
Yeah, he's moved our mirror from that wall to that wall.
He's done more than that. Can't you feel the influences running through the room?
Yeah.
I mean, you do know what this is, where we're sitting now, don't you? This is our love corner.
Oh.
Yeah.
Can I turn that round a bit?
No! No! You can't touch anything. You'll spoil the rhythms.
I can't see the screen.
When we want to watch telly, we move to our creative corner. Dex, Aren't you pleased we did it? Aren't you pleased that we're now under the influence of Feng Shui?
Jean, where's our blowjob corner?
Dexter!
Who wrote Pride and Prejudice?
Andrew Lloyd Webber.
Yes!
No.
A word, cock. Now, you're obviously a bright lad, university and what have you. So, before you venture forth as a minicab driver, I'm going to give you a very important piece of advice.
Oh, I'm not going to be a minicab driver for long. I've got a university degree.
What in?
Greek history.
You're going to be a minicab driver for bloody years, son. So listen carefully. Do not, and I cannot emphasise this enough, do not engage your punter in interesting or controversial topics. Save all your opinions on politics, art, music, religion and moussaka for your rag days. A punter doesn't like to feel inferior to their driver, so never challenge their intellectual capacities, stimulate their cerebral juices or whet their academic appetites with polemics. Cab drivers have a long and well-earned tradition of talking cobblers. Your duty is to maintain that tradition. There are certain things in this world you never hear nor see. A beggar without a little dog, a fat vampire, and a cabbie who talks sense. Learn to speak bollockese.
Bollockese?
The ancient art of talking non-stop, trite, cliched, illogical piffle whilst keeping a straight face. Think Chelsea supporter. Let that be your mantra. Welcome to Cresta Cabs. Driving along.
Stay with us here on UK Gold. Our regular double shift with the Bill begins after the break.